Hello, welcome back. We were seeing different types of sliding window protocols, right? And in the session also, we are going to the details of one specific type of sliding window protocol, that is go back in ARQ. As you know, the major design goal of this sliding window protocol is to increase the channel bandwidth utilization, right? And we have seen one basic version of the sliding window protocol, that is called 1-bit sliding window protocol. And there we saw that it's similar to the stop and wait protocol, right? The sender is able to send the second frame only after receiving the acknowledgement for the first frame. So definitely the channel utilization is not at all improved. Channel is idle most of the time, right? So how to improve the utilization? Yeah, definitely the solution is to allow the sender to send W frames before blocking instead of just one. So in case of stop and wait, the sender is blocked after sending the first frame and it is unblocked only after receiving the acknowledgement back, right? Instead of that, if the sender is allowed to send W frames before it receives the acknowledgement back, so we have to select this W in a proper way so as to improve the channel utilization and at the same time without overwhelming the receiver. The sender should not block or overwhelm the receiver by continuously sending frames, right? So such a value should be selected for W. And using this technique, so that is continuously passing or transmitting frames through this channel, we can treat this channel as a pipe, right? And continuously sending frames to fill the channel utilize, to fill the channel always without making this channel idle. Such a technique is called pipelining. So using this pipelining, we can improve the channel utilization. So as you know, the channel capacity can be measured using a bandwidth into delay product, right? And this product determines W. We have to efficiently use this channel, but at the same time flow control should be assured. And we have two terms in sliding window protocol. One was sending window and the second one was receiving window. Sending window is the set of sequence numbers corresponding to the frames it is permitted to send. The sending window actually contains two categories of frames. First one is a set of frames already sent but not yet acknowledged. That also will be there. And secondly, the set of frames which is ready to be sent. Okay, so why the first category is kept there? Because if the corresponding data frame is not received properly in the receiver, the sender may have to retransmit it later. That is why it is buffered again. Okay, these two categories of frames will be there in the sender window. And at the receiver side, it keeps a set of sequence numbers corresponding to the frames it is permitted to accept. So whenever a new frame is received by the receiver, it will check whether it is the one I am expecting, whether it falls in the window I am expecting. Okay, only if that falls in the corresponding receiving window, that corresponding frame is received. Otherwise, it will be simply rejected. So this is one way of ensuring the flow control. Okay, this example will give you an idea about how this window, sending window or receiving window works. Okay, so let us take the value of W, that is the window size, as 7 here. Both sending window and receiving window is having the same size. It need not be the same always. Okay, for simplicity we are taking both as the same value. Okay, so initially this is the status of sending window. The sender is ready to send frame 0 through frame 6 and it can start sending starting from the first frame, that is frame 0. So it's sending frame 0. And at the second time frame, this is the status of sending window. Frame 0 is already sent but not yet acknowledged. That is why it is shown in a different color to differentiate between this frame already sent and yet to be sent. Okay. And this frame should be there until it is acknowledged. Okay. And 1 to 6 are yet to be sent and frame 1 is sending now. And the current status of receiving window is that it received first frame, frame 0 from the receiver. Now it is expecting frame 1 to 6 and the third time frame, this is the status, frame 2 is sent by the sender. Frame 0 and frame 1 is already sent and waiting for the acknowledgement. Meanwhile, this is the status of receiver. It received frame 0 and 1 It sends back acknowledgement for the frame 0, sending a frame acknowledgement ACK0 to the sender. So on receiving this ACK0, that means the frame 0 is correctly received at the receiver. So it need not be kept in the buffer again, right? So this window is just forwarded to the next position. Now the window is from 1 to 7, right? 1, 2 are already sent, 3 to 7 is ready to send. Okay, and here you can see that upon sending an acknowledgement back, the receiver's window is already also advanced. Now it is waiting for frames from 3 to 7. Okay, so here also the advancement is done when the corresponding acknowledgement is sent back. Like this, all the frames are sent and received and the corresponding windows are advanced. So this is the basic idea about how the sender and receiver advances its window properly. Now you understood how the sliding window protocol works, right? Using this window, the sender is keeping this channel busy most of the time. Maximum it will send frames throughout this channel and thereby utilizing the channel efficiency in a maximum way, at the same time ensuring flow control by using a buffer size at the receiver window, right? So but the question here is, if the channel is unreliable, what happens? Okay, if you are using this protocol in a wireless network, lot of errors can be there in between, right? So here if you are using this protocol, the sender is continuously sending a long stream of frames without bothering about whether it is received correctly or not in the receiver, right? And there can be some errors in between, in middle of this long stream of frames. So how such errors can be handled? Definitely some of the frames may be damaged or some other may be lost. In such cases, how this protocol handles such errors? Okay, so based on this error handling in this sliding window protocol, we have two different approaches. Those are called go back N and second one is selective repeat. So go back N, you can think about the corresponding working, right? From the name itself, go back N times. That does if the receiver receives a frame in error, the receiver simply discard all the subsequent frames. That means the sender will time out after some time for this damaged frame, right? And it will send all the frames again starting from the damaged one. That is the first case. The problem here is definitely if there is a high error rate, lot of retransmission will be required, right? So channel efficiency will be affected in a negative way. So to reduce this number of retransmissions, we are using the second one, selective repeat. So you can guess what can be from this name itself, right? Selective repeat. We are repeating only the selective frame. Which frame? Yeah, only the damaged or lost frame will be retransmitted. Others will be buffered by the receiver. Okay, so there should be enough buffer space in the receiver. Then only this second method will work. Okay, so what the receiver will do is, when it sees a frame in error, okay, it will just discard that frame and the subsequent frames, it will be simply buffered in its detailing layer itself. Okay, and later when it receives the correct frame for the damaged one, it will make in order delivery in the network layer. Like that, if it receives the frame out of sequence, when an out of sequence frame will be received, yeah, the expected one is actually lost. That is why the next frame will be received. In that case also, it will simply buffer all these subsequent frames and later it will send this to network layer when the damaged or lost frame is received correctly. So this is the second one. So we can see all these two techniques in detail. So in this session, we will cover the go back N protocol, and the second next session, we will see the selective repeat. So go back N sliding window protocol. Receiver simply discards all the subsequent frames. So whenever receiver sees a damaged frame or it receives a frame out of order, that means the expected one is lost. Okay, in these two cases, the receiver simply discards all the subsequent frames. And it does not send any acknowledgement to the discarded frames. Okay, So how the sender will know that my frame is not received in the receiver? Yeah, definitely a timer will be set for a frame in the sender, right? The sender will time out after some time and will understand that this frame is not received correctly in the receiver. I have to retransmit. Okay. So what the receiver will do, what the sender will do, the sender will time out eventually and retransmit all the unacknowledged frames starting from the lost or damaged frame. So this is how go backing works. So definitely this is a problem. Lot of bandwidth will be wasted if error rate is high. Okay. Now you can see an example. Okay. So here the sender is sending a sequence of frames to the receiver. Frame 0 is received correctly. Frame 1 also received correctly. And what happens to frame 2? Yeah, it is damaged. It is an error. Okay. So what the receiver will do is it will discard this frame and all subsequent frames until it receives the correct frame for the frame 2. Okay. So all the subsequent frames will be discarded. Meanwhile, what happens to sender is not knowing all these things, right? It simply send other frames 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, up to 8 it's sending. By that time, it getting a timeout from this frame 2. Okay. So then only it realizes that, my frame 2 is not yet received correctly. I have to repeat everything from frame 2 again. So it will retransmit every frame starting from this frame 2. 2 to 8 will be retransmitted. Upon receiving this frame 2 correctly by the receiver will accept it, and further all the frames will be accepted by the receiver. And a corresponding acknowledgement will be sent back to the sender. So this is how the go back and sliding window protocol works. So in order to implement this go back and sliding window protocol, we have to maintain a set of pointers. You can see here a base pointer is here. Next sequence number pointer is also there. This is the current window. Okay, this box is the current window. Within that we have two types of frames. The light blue color frames indicates the frames which are already sent but not yet acknowledged. And the second, we have gray color frames, which are the frames which are yet to be sent. Okay. And the dark blue color frames, which are the frames which already sent and acknowledged. That is why it is coming out of the window. Okay. So base always points to the first frame in this window. And the next sequence number points to the frame to be sent next. Okay. So always this next sequence number pointer should be within this window. If it's coming out of the window, that means the sender should be blocked. Okay. After sending every frame, this next sequence number will be advanced to point to the next frame. Okay. This is how this go back and works. Now through an example, let us think about how the window size is chosen actually. Okay. So here the small n represent the number of bits for the sequence number in different frames, and the capital N represent the window size, the number of frames in a window. Okay, just for example, suppose the small n is 2. We are taking 2 bits for representing a sequence number for different frames. So totally we can have 4 different frames, right? Numbered from frame 0 through frame 3. Okay, so these are the possible sequence numbers for the frames, and so totally we can have 4 different frames, right? Okay, so if we are taking this 2 raised to n, that is 4, as the window size capital N, what happens we can see. So this is a sender window, that is 0 through 3 is the current sending window, and receiver also, suppose the size of the window is 4, 0 through 3 are the expecting frames in receiver. And suppose this is the current scenario, frame 0 is already sent, and the sender is waiting to send 1, 2 and 3, and after some time this is the status of receiver. Frame 0 is received correctly and the corresponding acknowledgement is sent back, so it just advances its window to next set of frames. Okay, 4, 1, 2, 3 and again a 0. Okay, so this is the current receiving window. But here this cannot be advanced. Why? The frame 0, the corresponding acknowledgement is lost. So again, this is the status of sender. It sends the second frame. Okay, frame 1 is sent, 2 and 3 are yet to be sent. Frame 1 is also received correctly in the receiver, so receiver will advance its window. Okay, so it will advance its window to the next 4 frames, starting from 2, 3, again 0 and 1. That will be the sequence number expected by the receiver here. You can see that the corresponding frame 1 acknowledgement is also lost due to some issues in the network. Again, this sender will send the next frame. Frame 2 is sent, that also received correctly. Frame 3 is sent, that also sent correctly. All those acknowledgement is lost. Let us take such a situation. So receiver, everything received correctly, it will just advance its window to receive the next frame. Okay. So now thus, after receiving the first 4 frames correctly, the next sequence number of the frame expected is 0 here. Okay. Next turn, right? And suppose after this much time, all the 4 frames sent, the sender is timing out for its first frame. It not yet received any acknowledgement, right? So it will definitely, it will time out after some time. For frame 0, it timeouts. So what the sender will understand, oh, my first frame is not yet received in the receiver. I have to resend it. Okay. So this frame 0 will be retransmitted again by this sender, frame 0. Okay. Upon receiving this by the receiver, what the receiver will check? Whether it is 0, I am expecting a 0 and the received one is also 0. But actually this one was the one sent by the sender, right? It's actually a retransmission, but receiver will mistakenly accept it thinking that the other, this is the one received for the next window. Okay, so if you are taking this window size as 2 raised to n, this is the problem caused. So we have to change the value. So the maximum size should be 2 raised to n minus 1. So n is the capital N is actually 2 raised to n, where small n is the number of bits in the sequence number. So this should be the maximum window size. Then only this protocol works correctly. So let us take the same case, that is we have 2 bits to represent sequence number. So capital N is 4. So the window size should be maximum 3. So here we can see an example. Sender window is size 3. 0, 1, 2 are the current window. Here also 3 is the size. Okay. So current scenario, sender send the first frame and waiting for the acknowledgement. 1, 2 are yet to send. After some time, this is the status. Okay. So all the 3 are sent by the sender, but all the corresponding acknowledgements are lost, as just like as a previous case. And what happens after some time, this sender will time out and will send the frame 0 again. But here you can see that the next frame expected in the case of receiver is sequence number 3, right? It advances to the next window where the starting frame is frame number 3. So when this frame 0 is received again, this is not the one I am expecting. So it will be simply discarded. Okay. So the window size always should be 1 less than the maximum range of values. Okay. So next session we can see the second type of sliding window protocol, that is selectively repeat. Okay. Thank you.